Demonstrations have continued on the streets of Melbourne as a significant police presence faces off with those protesting the Land Forces Expo. Police have made several arrests this morning as they attempt to minimise further disruptions to the city. Abby Dinham is there for us. Abby, what's the atmosphere like on the last day of the expo?
Narelle, it's been relatively peaceful on the last day. As you can see behind me, there's just a couple of dozen protesters here who are far outnumbered by police. We've got hundreds of officers from general duties to public order response teams. We've just heard from the Greens member David Shoebridge has been out addressing the crowds, but mostly people have been singing and sitting in silence. Occasionally we see someone from the delegation walking through the crowds. They get jeered, but that's as far as it's gotten. Earlier this morning at around 7:30, two protesters drove a car out onto a city overpass and parked it in the middle there to disrupt traffic. One woman got out and secured her hand to the boot of the car. Now, police managed to pull that car off the road with her still connected, and they cleared that way within, I'd say, about an hour. Then the protesters moved to this side of the exclusion zone. Police have about 250 metres blocked off from the entrance. They've been walking around and checking people's bags, telling people to take off their masks, but it's been largely peaceful so far. While inside, the Defence Minister has addressed the crowds defending holding the event.
This is a really important convention, which is ultimately about keeping Australia safe.
And so while there have been a number of arrests today, that's mainly been from police units who have been going out, walking through the crowds, checking people's bags, telling them to take their masks off and then arresting them if they haven't complied. We've only seen about five or six arrests so far this morning, so nothing compared to the chaotic scenes we've seen the last 2 days. Narelle?
Thanks for that, Abby Dinham there.